thank your president, the president of Whiriri Mayflower, Mervyn Rogers, and his wife Jane. Thank you. Mayflower Char tonight. Before we start the evening, we welcome the following friends to our dinner tonight. District Governor-elect Leslie Sully and her husband Martin, the President of Billericay Club, Peter Green and his wife Wendy, the President of our Satellite Club, Lynn Talbot and her husband, our Platinum sponsors from the Bursley Golf Club, Stuart and Michael and Michelle Mentz. Michelle. I've seen, I know. Also joining us tonight are other good friends, past President Reg Gilbert and Nicole, past District Governor Brian Hill Cottingham and Liz, Richard Dixter, Lee and his wife Sarah, Tony Spratling and his partner Angela. You are all very welcome. DG, Rotarians, ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for grace by the Vice President of Billericay Mayflower, Carl Johnson.
In a world where so many are hungry, may we eat this food with humble hearts. In a world where so many are lonely, may we share this friendship with joyful hearts. Amen. Amen.
Upstanding. Thank you. The President is going to toast the Queen. President.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Her Majesty the Queen.
Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, without any further ado, I call upon the District Governor-elect Leslie Sully to propose a toast to the Rotary Club of Billericay Mayflower. Thank you.
Just very great debate whether I need a microphone. I'll say it before you do. When I was invited to say a few words about the Rotary Club of Billericay Mayflower, I thought back to when I first became aware of one of the largest Rotary Clubs in Essex and Hertfordshire. What were my initial encounters with this club? Then I remembered back to the 23rd of October 2013, when a very bleary-eyed Nick Lamborn and Andy Hunter visited my Rotary Club, the Rotary Club of Colchester Centurion, during my year as club president. Bleary-eyed, because when I invited them along as speakers, they thought 7 o'clock for a Rotary Club meeting seemed ideal. What they had not initially realised was that our club meets at 7 o'clock in the morning. Nick and Andy had agreed to come along to our club to speak about a Rotary project the Rotary Club of Billericay Mayflower were undertaking, and for which they needed financial support from other Rotary clubs in the district, the Thrift College. Nick gave one of his extremely passionate talks, I'm sure you're all very familiar with that, which resulted in our club holding an event to support this extremely worthwhile project. I was therefore delighted just 3 months later to make my very first visit to the Rotary Club of Billericay Mayflower to present a cheque on behalf of the Rotary Club of Colchester Centurion. I remember well the meeting venue, the Rose Hall in Chapel Street. An interesting building with, I understand, an equally interesting history. Later that year, Martin and I joined you for your Billericay Christmas Market planning meeting, held at the Bursford Golf Club, and what an eye-opener that was. The hours and hours of planning, the large number of organisations and people involved, and the incredibly early start for those who had the job of closing the votes. That was just amazing and a credit to every single member of this outstanding club. In 2016, we joined you here at your 26th charter night. And then on a gloriously sunny December day, the same year, we were pleased to spend the whole day at your Christmas market as volunteers, helping as and where we could. I seem to recall spending a good part of that day on the Rotary Club of Basildon stall selling helium-filled balloons. More recently, I have been absolutely thrilled and delighted to support and work alongside E4 and Alastair in the formation of your brand new satellite club, and to witness firsthand the inauguration of its founder members just a few weeks ago. And it's lovely to see you here as well. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the Rotary Club of Billericay, and Peter's here on our table, who 28 years ago had the foresight to sponsor the then brand new Rotary Club of Billericay Mayflower. And you, as you know, have grown over the years from strength to strength. To all members of the Rotary Club of Billericay Mayflower, I take my hat off to you. You hold two major fundraising events in the town with Summerfest and the Christmas Market. You undertake numerous projects both locally and globally. You raise tens of thousands of pounds for deserving causes year after year. And you have now sponsored a satellite club with its more relaxed, informal format. You are an example to us all. As you celebrate your 28th charter night, I am delighted to once again be amongst so many friends and to share your evening with you. Please could I now ask all guests here this evening to stand and join me in a toast to the Rotary Club of Billericay Mayflower.
Mr. President, your response. Thank you very much, Mr. Master of Ceremonies. Can you hear me, everyone? No? Never mind. District Governor-elect Leslie, President Peter, Chairman Lynn, Rotarians, ladies and gentlemen. Leslie, thank you very much for your kind words. It's a lovely executive summary, what I'm about to say in the rest of my speech. And of course it is my privilege and duty to respond to your toast. Thank you. I'm proud to be a Rotarian because Rotary is a force for good in the world. The eradication of polio in the world is now in sight. A campaign which Rotary took to the World Health Organization some time ago. With help from the Bill Gates Foundation, we have nearly achieved our goal. I'm also very proud to be president of the Rotary Club of Billericay Mayflower, a strong club with 49 members. I am delighted that members of our newly formed satellite club are here tonight, led by Lynn Tolman. Billericay Mayflower organise two major community service events each year, Billericay Christmas Market and Summerfest. Both events also raise substantial funds for our charitable trust. In the past year, over £28,000 and £6,000, respectively. The staging of these events is a massive task which involves each member of our club, and we are also grateful to fellow Rotarians in Billericay Rotary Club and also to Billericay Roundtable for their help on the day. I would like to personally thank the organisers of these events, David Randall and Carl Johnson, and their teams for the hard work that they put in to ensuring the success of these events. I'd also like to thank the unsung heroes of the operations team who worked long and social hours to do the heavy lifting on the day. I would also like to welcome tonight platinum sponsor of our major events, the Birstead Golf Club. Stuart and Michelle, thank you very much for your continuing support. We expect to raise over £40,000 this year for good causes. Over 40% of this goes to local charities, such as BOSS. See, I did mention it, Keith. Such as BOSS, Barrow Farm Riding for the Disabled, Anvil Trust, Mount Essing Court, Kids Out, Chelmsford Men's Sheds, Billericay Art Trail, and Night Shelter. We're always on the lookout for other local charities to support. I would also like to thank all members of Club Council for their tremendous support during the last year. I'd like to mention specifically the three committee chairmen, Carl Johnson, Mark Chambers and Colin Campbell, the club secretary, Ian Miller, and also the treasurer, Peter Walker. You have all guided me well throughout the year. Last but not least, I would also like to thank on your behalf the small team who organised Charter Night this year. That's Carl Johnson, Colin Campbell and Howard Watson. Well done, guys. I have one more important task to perform, to announce some special thank yous. In Great Britain, Rotary recognises individual Rotarians for their exceptional contribution to their club, their communities and to Rotary International with the award of a Paul Harris Fellowship. Those who receive the award get to wear a large gold disc on their lapels and sometimes on a ribbon around their neck. Tonight, I would like to award the fellowship to two Billericay Mayflower Rotarians. The first person I'd like to thank is here with his wife, Jill, who is a member of the Satellite Club. He is a past president who continues to make a major contribution to the club. He orchestrated the relocation of the club meeting venue from Rose Hall on Chapel Street to the Birstead Golf Club, a task which was not without controversy. He then took on the task of starting the satellite club, which included getting club members to agree with this proposition. Again, not an easy task. The Satellite Club members here tonight are testament to his success. I would like to award a Paul Harris Fellowship to E4 Roberts. Indeed, he wrote the infamous Blue Book and actively checks that it is adhered to. woe betide you if you don't. In the past 2 years, he has also made a major contribution to the overhaul of our websites, in particular the replacement of the Christmas Market and Summerfest sites. I'd like to award a Paul Harris Fellowship to Richard Rackham. Is time that is taken from my family. I would like to give a huge thank you to my wife Jane. For not only putting up with this and my railway hobby, I don't know if you guessed that from those photos, but for providing great support and encouragement throughout my time as Vice President and now as President. I'd also like to thank family and friends for their support during my year. Secondly, a president can only get through his or her year with the active support of all members of the club. I have been very fortunate this year to have enjoyed considerable support from club members, and I thank you all for a gift that is very, very much appreciated. Thank you. I hope that you're all having a great evening, and I look forward to some dancing when the speeches are finished. Thank you all for being here.
Thank you, Mr. President. I now call upon Richard Rackham to propose a toast to the ladies and guests. And the Rotarians only stand. Thank you, they expect me to speak now. Yeah. Mr. President, Madam District Governor-elect, Presidents, Dignitaries, Rotarians, ladies and gentlemen. It is traditional at Billericay Mayflower that the speech to propose a toast to the ladies and guests is a humorous speech designed to raise a wry smile as well as fulfilling the formalities of a quick thank you. But this year they asked me to do it. I normally, when I lecture to a group of people of this size, lecture on the application of ISO 22301 to pharmaceutical and other medical products, cold chains. So fasten your seatbelts for the excitement. I'd like to start by exposing one of the deep, dark secrets of the Rotary Club of Billericay Mayflower. It's over a century ago now that Paul Harris, the founder of Rotary, concocted an excuse to spend some time away from the wife. And Billericay Mayflower has continued to honour that great tradition by ensuring that almost every Thursday is an opportunity for the gentlemen of the club to go out for a swift tuff. We have invented many, many ways of making this appear a noble venture. I shouldn't say this next bit now. We award ourselves little medals. We run committees, which is actually another night out a week. We raise funds for charity, and we give each other titles like Mr. President, which sounds so much better than designated driver, doesn't it? Now, the world has changed considerably since the time of Paul Harris, and Billericay Mayflower has kept up with the times. We have lady members, and the ladies sacrifice themselves to a rather dull evening watching gentlemen of a certain age eat their meal and drink their wine. Now, it would be a bit dull, wouldn't it, if I just outlined this rather obvious artifice. So, I have been undercover. I have a contact on the other side. With Trump edging ever closer to a rerun of Watergate, I took inspiration from Woodward and Bernstein and found myself a deep undercover person. If you got that joke, you're ruder and quicker than I think you are. So, now really I address myself to the gentlemen of the club. Has it ever occurred to you that our Rotary attendance is just a little bit too easy? Have you noticed that we are encouraged in our Rotary activities? Our little bits of Rotary regalia are always available. Our Thursdays are magically always free. We organise a quiz where the rounds are called US state capitals and people called Michael, and our wives buy tickets. We arrange an event which is essentially screwing a wooden horse to a skateboard and dragging it towards us on a piece of string, and they bring their friends. We run an event where we're up at 5 o'clock in the morning and we don't get home until they're in bed, and they make us coffee and bacon butties. I think it's clear that something else is going on, and it's this. The ladies stay comfortably at home whilst we are out. They relish their Thursday nights with full command of the TV remote control and a bottle of Prosecco. The subterfuge is not played by us on the ladies, but by the ladies on us. Now, a slight aside here. When the concept of lady members was first mooted, Rotarians of Billericay Mayflower, having secured their lady free night, were understandably reticent. What I didn't understand was why their wives were also opposed. I thought originally they might be worried that the gentlemen's eyes would wander and there would be temptation. But then I thought, look at us. I mean, really, look at us. And tonight we're dressed up in our best bib and tucker. We don't normally even look this good. Then I got it. They were worried that they would be dragged along to a Thursday evening. And the thing is, they were right. One of our members brings his wife with him. They are newlyweds though, so that's understandable. And I do believe that he pays a different amount for his subs to all the other members to reflect that sacrifice. But back to my main point. And back to Woodward and Bernstein. One of their mantras was follow the money. Where does it come from? Where does it go? Now, in Billericay Mayflower, that's not an easy thing to do. We have a treasurer who hides this stuff in plain sight. In an email he sends out every month. So I had a look at this email, at the ancient runes and mysterious symbols that he calls the accounts. Now, this is serious. We all know that those organisations that are known entirely by acronyms are evil. KGB, CIA, MI5, HMRC, B&Q. It's well known. So I have searched through the accounts, and those organisations are there. BOSS. Actually, it's only BOSS, but I couldn't find another one. But it's there. So the question then is where does the money come from? And a significant amount comes from those who, in the title of this part of the evening's running order, are called the guests. This shadowy band funds this mutual deception between husband and wife that I've been describing. And the benefit to them is far from clear. Despite much searching, it's hard to find, and perhaps I ought to leave it to a subject of another talk. So this just leaves me with 3 points. Firstly, research of this quality takes a great deal of effort and a great deal of time. And so I've employed a partner to assist. The bill will be coming through, Peter. Unfortunately, they couldn't send it on time. They're having some trouble. They've had some urgent appointment recently and their computers appear to be down. But I would like to publicly thank Cambridge Analytica for all the hard work that they did. Secondly, of course, I've entirely wasted the last few minutes of your time. But the facts are true, even if the interpretation is just a mile away. This club does fantastic things, and it's hugely reliant on a great number of people that support financially, physically, and in many other ways. Not all of them can be here tonight, but they've all earned the deepest gratitude of the members of this club. And so lastly, I'd like to ask the members of the Rotary Club of Billericay Mayflower to stand and raise your glasses, please, to the ladies and guests.
everybody. You've now heard from all the important people, so it just remains for me to do the traditional bit and to say thank you all for coming along here tonight and for all the support that you've given to my husband during the last year. It's been a jolly year. There have been unexpected challenges and unexpected joys, but at the end of it, membership is at an all-time high. The club has raised a very large sum of money for various charities, and above all else, everybody seems to have enjoyed themselves over a 12-month period. So thank you all very much indeed for all the help and support that you've given Merv over the last 12 months. In that, I'd also like to include everybody who isn't here tonight and all the friends, neighbours and colleagues and family members who have come along to all the Rotary events and who have given so generously of their time and of their money during this period. Now, my second task tonight is to respond to Richard, which is of quite a different order of magnitude. We have heard that, in fact, gentlemen join Rotary in order to get away from their wives. Well, I think I may have spotted the tinsy little flaw in this argument. We stand here tonight in the presence of the district governor-elect.
Exactly.
There's Miss Gully. And congratulations, Mark, not on being a woman, that's just on being the district governor next year. In another 12 months, this club will have its first female chairman. Well done. President. Well done, Yvonne. And incidentally, Yvonne, thank you for all the wonderful photos and for the really interesting club newsletter. And shame on any of you who are not reading it regularly on the internet, because it's absolutely excellent. And finally, the satellite club is up and running and very successful. And in Mrs. Lynn Talbot has an inaugural president who is already proving to be as resourceful and dynamic as the many professional, capable women who are joining that organization. So gentlemen, there really is nowhere to hide. Now this is obviously a source of concern for some people, and I have put some thought into this. All I can suggest is a monastery. If all else fails, the Taliban. And Richard, they would love the beer. Overall, the sort of society created by misogynistic fanatics is always recruiting, because really life is short and wretched in such a miserable world. Overall, gentlemen, I think you're much happier and much safer here in Billericay with your wives who have nurtured, supported, comforted you, cosseted and protected the delicate male ego. And really taken care of you at every opportunity. So gentlemen, there's no hiding, just relax and enjoy it. And remember that no matter how good you are at whatever it is you do, behind you there is a woman thinking, I could do that so much better.
So the guest
stand. I don't know what you know about. Carl and Caroline, I ask you to come up as your name, both age or of President's wife and President of next summer.
Enjoy.
And to the President's good lady, Jane. And we also have a bonus ball. Carl is going to come around to see Colin with the bonus ball.
This is... Colin has put a hell of a lot of work into this with my work commitments, and I just wanted to give him a little present of a nice bottle of wine just to thank him formally from myself. Colin, thank you very much.